everyone. So nice to see you all again. Thanks for joining me, and welcome to the Ridge. Today I'm doing some gardening and visiting with the garden anoles. We just saw the female. Now here's her mate, the male. Oh, by the way, both of them still remain nameless. Right now, a pair of bugs in love have caught his attention. He gives them a look, then decides they're no threat, and lets them go about their business of prolificating their species, whatever that may be. It's that time of the year, and the mating games are in progress. There's a look out over the garden. I love the garden. I enjoy it. Sometimes it can be a lot of work, but it is, of course, a labor of love. It's a cloudy, overcast day. The reptiles are all out trying to soak in a few of those UV rays through the cloud cover. Oops, sorry about that. Give me a second. I'll find them. There she is, the female anole. And friend, a female skink. Both of them sharing the same territory. Although they are different species, their breeding habits are almost exactly the same. The anole tries for a fly, but misses. There is a delicate balance in nature. Predator versus prey. As long as there's enough for everyone, the balance will remain. All of a sudden, the male sends out a signal to the female. She heeds his warning and heads for cover. Oh, it's just Roxy, heading over to the fish pond for a cool drink. Roxy the dog is a predator, but these lizards have nothing to fear. As long as they remain still, Roxy will never even know they're here. As you can see, our friend, the cardboard box anole, is doing well. He's still living in his box. Meanwhile, out across the yard, Rico is doing well, even though one of his favorite boxes disappeared, that old air conditioner. But they're making use of the natural habitat, doing what anoles do, taking to the trees. By nature, anoles tend to be an arboreal species. That means they are quite comfortable living in trees. But they're not the only tree-dwelling species. As you can hear, there are lots of birds in the neighborhood. And many of these birds eat anoles, so they'll have to be careful. Rico's mate keeps in touch with him by doing a series of head bobs. Maybe this won't draw the attention of those birds. Time passes in the garden, as you can see by the growth of the vegetation. And before long, the skinks have also made themselves quite at home here as well. And finally, we get a better look at the pond monster. Now, whether or not this is the same bullfrog that's lived here for the past 4 years, known lovingly as Blobster, well, that is a question I just can't answer. Next door, one of the female slider turtles is nesting. She labors away intently, laying her eggs then burying her precious cargo. Depending on the species, the incubation period for turtle eggs is anywhere from 45 to 90 days. Now last year, y'all check it out, isn't it cute? I found 7 baby turtles, little hatchlings around the pond. Here's some video of them. Today I am happy to announce all 7 of them are doing just fine. However, the same cannot be said for this poor turtle's clutch. Sadly, her nest was destroyed by fire ants, therefore destroying any chance of hatchlings. Now, it's debatable within the scientific community as to whether or not reptiles feel anything akin to love. If they do, her labor of love has clearly been lost, at least for this season. But she'll try again next year. Thanks for watching.